In the recent videos, I've discussed how stars can become stressed, expelling vast amounts of material outwards. In other scenarios, the stars are thought to explode, causing the entire system to malfunction, creating repeating discharges that travel across the plasma, which acts like a transmission line. There are a number of different ways that stars are thought to explode, or nova, and although mainstream has an idea of how these scenarios can occur, there seem to be many exceptions that break these. So let's explore some of these strange explosions. Strange novas. A nova is a sudden explosion of bright light from a two-star system. The mainstream concept is that these are created in a binary system where one star is a white dwarf which pulls material from a companion star. Over time, the white dwarf draws enough material which heats up and causes an uncontrolled reaction that releases a burst of energy. This in turn shoots matter away at high speed. These events are therefore long-lived and usually fade over a couple of weeks or longer. On the 12th of June 2021, the nova V1674 Hercules underwent what appeared like a nova event with a sudden brightening which made it visible to the naked eye. By the next day, it had already faded. When astronomers studied the emissions, they discovered that it seemed to be pulsing. Every 501 seconds, there was a sudden change or pulse in the light and X-rays. Even after the light faded, this 501-second wobble was still present. When they went back and studied the emissions just prior to the nova, they discovered that this wobble was present even before the outburst and remained through the brightening event and afterwards. Supernovae are more energetic and leave little or nothing behind, unlike a nova. 10 years ago, supernova SN 2012Z was spotted in the nearby spiral galaxy NGC 1309. The event should have been the final swan song of the star. The galaxy has been observed for a long period of time, so it was possible to use this to work out exactly which star went bang by looking for the now empty space. They were expecting to see that the star was either completely gone, or maybe that it should still be there, meaning that the star that they observed was not the one that blew up. What they discovered was something that they did not expect to find. The star had survived, but it had somehow become brighter. This was not the first time that they had observed a star surviving a supernova, and was another star which would be added to the growing pile of stars that defied the supernova. Even when they die, some seem to defy even this process. In a recent analysis, astronomers used the data from the Hubble telescope to document the demise of a giant star 35 million light years from Earth. These seem to show something very unexpected. The cool yellow star had no hydrogen outer layer. In theory, if a star explodes without hydrogen, it should be extremely blue, meaning it is really very hot. It should not be possible for a star to be this cool without having hydrogen in the outer layer. The scientists examined every single mainstream model, and they all required the star to have hydrogen, which they knew from the supernova it didn't have. When they looked back to the images before the supernova, they saw a very normal hydrogen-free star, but the star did not match with the type of supernova they observed. They suggest that maybe the star shed its hydrogen shell years prior to the event, but it remains a mystery. In theory, these large supernova explosions should be final. The energies involved should rip the star apart, but even here, scientists have discovered a rather remarkable star that seems to be able to repeatedly supernova. In 2014, scientists captured a fading supernova near the constellation of Ursa Major. At first, it looked like every other supernova. Over 500 million light years away, in a galaxy so far it's little more than a smudge, a star exploded, not just once, but over 5 times over the course of 2 years. In the process, it ejected a vast amount of material equal to 50 Jupiters and emitted more energy than 10 quintillion, that's 10 to the power of 18, suns. 5 months later, when they went back to examine the data, someone spotted something strange. When they looked at a plot of the emissions over the last 137 days, it appeared like the explosion was getting brighter. So they decided to look at the spectrum of light from the star. This seemed to indicate that the Novae was only 30 days old, and yet they had concrete proof that it had in fact been going on for months. They continued to study it and followed the supernova as it brightened, then faded, then brightened again. It hit 5 peaks of brightness before finally dwindling out in the summer of 2016. At 600 days old, it was already the longest-lived supernova ever observed. They now turned to the historical archives and found that the same portion of sky had been observed in 1954 and 1993. In 1993, no supernova was evident, but in the 1954 image, there was a noticeable bright spot in the galaxy. As the galaxy is far away, it is not possible to make out individual stars. So there is a small possibility that the 1954 explosion is caused by another star. No mainstream model of stellar evolution can fully explain these observations. The energy released in the 2014 explosion is greater than their models predict. An analysis of the light coming from the explosion indicated that its chemical composition is different from what astronomers would expect. These findings question how much mainstream astronomers really know about supernovae. Maybe it's time for a new model.